Paul McGuire is an internationally recognized prophecy expert, minister, speaker, author of 34 books, and host of the Paul McGuire Report radio show every Monday through Friday, 4 to 6 p.m. Eastern Time. Paul has hosted 6 series of the exciting God TV television series called Apocalypse and the End Times. There's a picture of the back of his book. And his book is called The Greatest Battle for the Hearts and Minds of Mankind in the History of the World. Paul has been researching after he became a Christian through a radical experience of getting to know or meeting Jesus, getting to know Jesus and becoming a Christian, becoming a believer back in his 20s, I believe. After that, he started researching. God led him to research certain areas, and one area was communism and what's really behind communism. That, for example, in his own words, paraphrased by me, communism is just a tool that the globalist elite use. So I guess they finance it and they use it to enslave the masses. I will read a little bit out of this book concerning China. The copyright date of this book is 2019, so it's fairly up to date. There exists a secret occult destiny for America and the world, going all the way back to 1973, the late David Rockefeller, a prominent member of the globalist elite, wrote an article entitled From a China Traveler, which was prominently published in the New York Times on August 10, 1973. In this article, Rockefeller states, "The social experiment in China under Chairman Mao's leadership is one of the most important and successful in history." Continuing on in the book, at first glance, anyone reading Rockefeller's words praising China would assume that Rockefeller was a sociopath or delusional. However, Rockefeller is neither of these things. Rockefeller appears to have access to intelligence reports that the rest of us don't. Rockefeller knew exactly what really happened with Chairman Mao. and the Chinese Communist Revolution. When he writes the above praises about China, he knows what the American media, the American political class, and what the average American, or he knows that the average American have no clue about, or what they have no clue about. Communist China was artificially raised up to spread totalitarianism among the governments of the world, which would rule the masses by creating a slave class who were programmed to be unaware that they were slaves. Rockefeller was fully aware that Chairman Mao Zedong, through his Great Leap Forward policy, led to the deaths of over 45 million people in China, which makes it the biggest mass murder event ever recorded in human history. The National Socialist dictator Adolf Hitler and the Russian Communist Revolutionary Stalin, who both killed millions of people, did not even come close to the mass deaths of Chairman Mao from 1958 to 1962. Chairman Mao believed that he could catapult China above many nations in the world by forcing villagers to move out of remote rural areas into giant people's communes, with the lying promise, lying as opposed to truth telling, lying with the lying promise of a utopian paradise which will be collectivized, which means the individual must die and men and women must join the collective or the communist state. This is essentially the game plan of the United Nations Agenda 2030. And many of the socialist candidates running for political office in the US. So I'll stop there. But you guys, if you really want to get behind the scenes of what's really going on and who's pulling the strings in the world, and they've been doing it for decades, but even longer than that. It's actually a spiritual thing that's going on, but that's another subject for another day. The spiritual thing has to do naturally with spiritual entities. The Bible, Paul writes in the Bible that we struggle, or our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against principalities. And principalities and spiritual entities, powers in high places, evil spiritual entities. So you know who that leads to. On the one side, our enemy, the devil, which is Lucifer or Satan, and that's our enemy. So the battle is a spiritual battle against his plans, basically, because God has already won. As he raised Jesus from the dead, Jesus conquered death, right? Conquered death and hell when he was raised from the dead. But that's another story for another day. But if you're like me, you're wondering, how can these plans last for centuries? the plans of the so-called Illuminati or globalist elite, which actually Paul McGuire explains, it goes back to, these plans go back to Babylon, you know, and some say there was a, yeah, I'll just go to that point right now, but, well, if they're spiritual, if our struggle is spiritual and not political in nature, then that means the devil doesn't die. So that's why these plans are carried out. That's why these plans haven't died out. As, for example, David Rockefeller died, I think it was about 4 or 5 years ago. He was like 105 years old, but these plans are continuing, even though the human beings that have been carrying them out for decades get old and die. The plans continue. How can that be? Which political system or country has ever experienced something like that? That over hundreds of years, the same plans are just continued to be carried out. My answer would be it's because Satan is behind these plans. He doesn't die. People do, but he doesn't. So he gets it in the heads of the next generation. And the next generation, he keeps the plans going. That's biblical, because this is all leading to, if you read Revelation chapter 13, when the Antichrist is going to want you to either worship him and take the mark of the beast or be killed. So anyway, this is a spiritual problem that we got. It's not a political one. I just read also in the Bible, just by the way, there will come a time when those who are alive and who believe in Jesus will be confronted with the necessity of making a choice of bowing down to the Antichrist, to this, maybe before that, to this world system, which is already being constructed worldwide, not just in America, but we see it going on in Germany and in Europe and other countries of the world. But mostly right now in America and in Europe, Germany specifically. Probably because these are two, America and Germany are two of the strongest Western civilized nations economically and so what they manufacture, are able to manufacture and whatnot, for example. Anyway, the globalists want to take these countries down. So that everything's evil, equal, excuse me, equal. And then they can control the world better when there's no America. You know, Germany, specifically Germany, but they want to take Europe altogether, take them down. If they're going to control the masses, these two countries have to go. Anyway, but I was reading that we will overcome those believers who are left facing this decision of worshiping the beast or the Antichrist, can defeat him, at least for a while with the words of their testimony and the blood of the Lamb. The blood of the Lamb is the blood of Jesus. Jesus is the Lamb that was slain before the foundations of the world. That's just a term. Well, I mean, that's a whole theological discussion, but Jesus is the Lamb, and he was slain, he was crucified. He was God's son, or is God's son. He was crucified for our sakes, yours and mine. Because he was obedient to the Father, and the Father loves us so much that he gave his only begotten son. He gave his only son, Jesus. And those who believe in him should not perish and have everlasting life. That's John 3:16 out of the Bible. Anyway, I didn't want to go this direction actually, but I can't help it. It's just, that's the ultimate truth. That's what everybody needs to have at least had a chance to hear and to had a chance to decide for themselves what they're going to believe. But this book, The Greatest Battle, for the hearts and minds of mankind in the history of the world, I would highly suggest it. Paul McGuire is the author. I would highly suggest getting this book as at least a foundation of what's going on in the world, how we got to this point. See, he's a professor from a Bible professor also, and he's taught on Bible universities. Let me just read through the table of contents. I didn't plan on doing this. I didn't plan on making such a long video, but this book is, it's incredible if you want to get a good documented history of the world spiritually, behind the scenes, what's been going on, and as to why we're at the point we are now. So I'll just say, for example, there's a couple, I'll just go through real quick and maybe skip over some, but there's an interesting one to maybe get your goat, get you a little curious, get you maybe a little mad. Victoria's Secret, supermodel witch. It has something to do with Tom Brady, the quarterback. Yes, I'm talking about the football player. So it goes on down. The technocratic elite and sorcery. See, the globalist elite, it seems that they always gravitate towards spiritual, the occult, not the Christian spiritual, unfortunately. But that's, yeah, that's the way it is. So, witchcraft, evangelism, music stars, Hollywood, Illuminati, and Satanism. Oh, here's another one that might get your goat a little bit. Might kind of prick you a little bit, get you a little upset. David Bowie, Dark Star, another capital, Eternity's Quest, and the Divine Reboot. Sounds kind of like the Big Reset, right? Maybe. I haven't read that, this capital, but occult, global elite, finance. The occult, global elite, finance, communist revolutions. That's what I was saying a while ago concerning David Rockefeller. A telepathic encounter with a guru and the hive mind. Hive mind, that is a term you might want to become familiar with. Oh, by the way, have you heard that the incredibly big computer or computer storage, electronic storage, electronic transmission storage center in Utah is called the Beast, I believe. Yeah, good. It's just a nickname, huh? But it's a little bit on the in the same going down the same path of the subject of the hive mind. But look, check into that. The Frankfurt School, the plan to destroy Christianity and the Western culture. He documents all these, everything he says is documented. He studies and researches these things. That's what God has led him to do. That's his calling as a Christian. And he's been doing it for over 45 years. America, Babylon, American anarchy. The all-seeing eye, America's prophetic destiny, Illuminati goals and planetary dictatorship, the one world United Nations Agenda 2030 decoded. Airborne vaccines, infected brain cells, genetically modified organisms, the 10 plagues of Egypt and Armageddon, seven seal judgments, seven trumpet judgments, and seven vial judgments. That's in Revelation, Book of Revelations. I guess the revelation of, you got me there. I'll stop there. That's the Book of Revelation, the last book in the Bible. The secret occult destiny of America, hidden dangers of 5G technology. Oh, that's gonna get some people a little riled up. Rise of autoimmune and man-made diseases. Nikola Tesla and unlimited fry, well, fry, I'm speaking German, unlimited free energy. Okay, and the last chapter seems to be the prophetic role of China and the one world government, which, let me just say, out of the one world government is going to rise the Antichrist. That's what I've been learning since I read my first book when I was 15. It's been quite a few years, also about 45 years, a little over 40 years. That book was called When Your Money Fails. That was the first book I read concerning all this kind of stuff. Oh, by the way, I was going to say concerning these conspiracy theories, but Paul McGuire actually had researched the term conspiracy theory, and guess where that came from? One of our, I think it was one of our CIA, our US CIA directors, I believe, want somebody in a high position coin that phrase in order to do exactly what it does, to discredit truth. Oh, that's just conspiracy theory. Then people just going about their business, say, ah, yeah, who cares? It's conspiracy theory. It works fantastically, right? Some things are maybe a little not quite true, but a lot of things that are considered conspiracy theory aren't conspiracy theory. Oh, by the way, also one of our agency directors, maybe the CIA, it was, said also, according to Paul McGuire, he said, "We will know we have been successful when all Americans believe the lie, the lies that we've been propagating, that we've been putting out there." That's something to that effect. So, People. We've been watching too much TV, man. Too much TV. I mean, Paul McGuire talks about the effects of TV, the programming, getting into brainwashing. And for example, if you repeat something enough, people will start to believe it and just believe it, you know, just by repeating something again and again and again. You might want to notice some of these things when you're watching TV is something that repeated. I don't know, it's just, I'm not an expert on that, but just for an example. I hope that this might inspire some of you to buy this book and to maybe come out of the stream, the mainstream, the river that everybody's going down, just to be going down it because everybody else is doing it. I would be successful with this video if one person would say, maybe there's something to this stuff, and get out of the mainstream river and start going upstream, go the other direction, get out of the river and walk away from it and start doing some thinking and some research, reading, watching, listening on your own, and basically wake up out of this daze, this haze that America is in. Oh, Paul McGuire has also said that they put fluoride in the drinking water, that and fluoride makes you passive. Supposedly, I think it was him that said Hitler did that to the Germans to make the population more easily to control. Okay, you see, the devil's always about control and suppression, oppression, and worse, like in the case of Chairman Mao in China. But the Bible says where the Spirit of the Lord is liberty, is freedom. Come on, America, the rest of the world. We've had it too easy for too long, I guess. What do they say in Rome? Give the people bread and games, and you can do whatever you want to with them. I guess, unfortunately, I think that's what's happened to us in America.